This is just Red Heart acrylic yarn, size 4. Okay. I'm gonna start by making a magic ring. Oops. And I'm going to single crochet 10 inside. And I'm gonna close my ring. And I'm gonna go inside of the first single crochet that we did, and I'm just gonna slip stitch. So this one right here. Okay. And then I'm just gonna chain up 2. And that's what we're gonna do for every row, essentially, is chain up 2. At the start, 1, 2, and then I'm going to single crochet 2 in each stitch that we've done, okay? So we'll end up with 20 at the end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. This last stitch right here, 19, 20. Okay, this is essentially kind of what we're gonna do for every row for the bottom, for the start of the dome. So I'm gonna slip stitch again into the first single crochet that we did. Okay, and again at the start, you're gonna wanna chain 2. And this is optional, but you can weave in this by just like going along and crocheting with it, like going in the first stitch, grabbing it in the back while also grabbing your main piece of yarn and going through and then just crocheting. Okay, for this row we're going to do 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet in 1 stitch, 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet, and by the end of this row we'll have 30. So we're like gradually increasing. So 1, 2. Okay, so I did 1 single crochet in this first stitch that we did, and then I did 2 single crochet in the second stitch. Okay, so I increased on the second one, so not increasing on the next one, and then increasing. So I'm just going back and forth. I probably should have used a lighter yarn so I could see it and you guys could see it too. I'm sorry. I've just been kind of craving a dark blue jellyfish recently, so I figured, why don't I also just make a video about it as well. Okay, so I'm on my 40th stitch. I know I said go until 30, but I meant 40. So when we're, the rows will go up by like 3. So we're increasing every 3rd stitch, and so I'll have 40 stitch total. And the next one, increase every 4th stitch, and then we'll have 50 stitches total, and it'll go up like that. I'm sorry, I had to go back and look. So I'm on my 40th stitch. I'm going to slip stitch into the first single crochet that we did. Okay, and then I'm going to chain up 2. The start of every row will be a chaining up 2. Okay, Next, we're gonna go increase every fourth stitch, and this will be the last one that I do until I get like to the end. I'm gonna show you a little tip for people that like have trouble, like they lose count, because I know I do. So I'm going to single crochet one in the first stitch, single crochet one in the second stitch, single crochet one in that third stitch, and then the fourth stitch is where we do the increase. So notice how I'm at three, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna put that fifth single crochet in that fourth one, 5. So what you'll realize if you're counting like one by one all the way around is that it's divisible by 5. So I know I feel like I'm saying a lot of numbers and there's a lot of math, but it's just a little helpful tip. You don't have to do this. You can use stitch markers or whatever helps you. But for me, I don't have the materials, so this is what I do to, it's just easy for me. Again, it's at 5 right now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that was 10, okay? 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15 will go in that same one, okay? All right, and all the way around until we get to 50, all right? So just to like kind of recap, if you want to do this tip, then it's going to be divisible by 5, okay? For your, when you're increasing by 4, it's going to be divisible by 5, okay? Increasing every fifth stitch is going to be divisible by 6. For the 6, every 6th increase, divisible by 7, and so on and so on. And then also for every row, we're going to have, you're going to increase by, like, for this next row, you're going to increase every 5th stitch, and then you're going to have 60 stitches total, okay? Then for that next row, you're going to increase every 6th stitch, and then have 70 stitches total. So that kind of goes with it. Okay, so I am done. I finished with increasing every 8th stitch, so I have a total of 90. Yes, it looks like it's curling up a bit, because when you increase, it tends to add ruffles when you do that. So you can just like pull it a little bit, flatten it out, make it a little easier, manipulate it a little bit. It doesn't need to be blocked, in my opinion. Nobody's really going to see the bottom. You just kind of need that base part for the dome part, okay? So this is like good enough. And then we're going to do one more round. Okay, so I already slip stitch into the first single crochet and I chained up 2. Next, what we're going to do, we're just going to put a half double crochet, one half double crochet in each stitch, all 90 stitches, okay? That's it. And hopefully doing this row will also get it to like flatten and like spread out a bit more, okay? So again, that first stitch is where we're going to put the half double crochet, not in any chain 2 space. Same for the first and the last stitch, okay? One in each stitch. And there should be about 90 stitches, I believe. Like, it shouldn't go up or down since we're not increasing or decreasing, okay? And I'll be back once I'm done. And after that, we can go ahead and start on the dome. Okay, so I just finished with my half double crochet row, and then I slip stitch into that first half double crochet that we did, and then just pulled all the way through and cut my yarn at the end. And now I'm going to weave it in and tie it off and stuff, okay? Again, it's okay, like, if it's not, like, completely flat, look at that, it's fine. I just, kind of flatten it out, kind of manipulate it a bit. Excuse the beads. I'm gonna add the beads to the dome or some kind of accessory during, like, I'm gonna put the beads on the yarn. I'm gonna try, I don't know, I've seen others do it. So we're gonna start off by doing a slip knot for the dome. We're gonna put that piece aside for now, and usually I would do both of them together, but it's just easier to work with the dome in this part separately, because you could also add the tentacles a lot easier. You'll see what I mean later on. You can sew everything on easier. Okay, you can also sew with a crochet hook, so darn. All right, so I did a slip knot. Now I'm gonna chain 90, okay? Now that I have 90, I'm just going to make this all the same way. Make sure it's not tangled at all, okay? And I'm going to slip stitch into the first chain that we did, okay? Sorry, my yarn was a little tangled. Pull that. And again, make sure none of it's tangled and it's all like the same direction all the way through. Otherwise, you'll be crocheting it and it'll be twisted. And you can't untwist it. You'll have to frog everything, okay? So again, just like before, every row will start with a chain two. Not counted as a stitch. It's just to prevent space, okay? And for this, we're going to half double crochet all the way through. Half double crochet one in each stitch, okay? We're gonna have a 90 total half double crochet. And at the end of your row, I'll recap this when I get to it, but at the end of the row, every row, like if you wanna go ahead, at the end of every row, you just slip stitch into that first half double crochet that we did before, and then chain up two, and then go ahead and start your new row of doing one half double crochet all the way around. And we're basically gonna repeat doing that for about 18 rows total, 18 or 20. We're not gonna be increasing or decreasing until we get to until we finish the dome part and get to the ruffles. Okay, I'll be back once I'm done with this row, just to again recap what I'm doing for the next row and what I'll be doing for the next 19, 18 rows. It depends on how big you want it to be, like how long you want it to be, but it's like half an inch, so it won't really make a difference. Okay, here I am at the end of my row. Again, make sure it's not twisted while you're crocheting, otherwise it'll be like twisted to where you can't untwist it. It's just complicated. Okay, like I said, for every row, when you end, you're going to slip stitch in that first, the first half double crochet we did, not the chain two space, okay? And the stitch count should stay the same each time, okay? Because we're not increasing or decreasing anywhere. And then I'm going to chain up two, and again, just half double crochet all the way around for like 18, 19 more rows, up to you, okay? Okay, so I ended up doing 20 stitches total. Okay, this is how it looks. Here's the inside. It looks pretty neat and nice still, okay? So what we're gonna do now is we're just going to, in this row, we're still gonna use this color, but we're gonna create loops for the drawstring to go through. So I'm just gonna slip stitch, like I've been doing at the end of every row, into the first half double crochet we did, and then chain up two. This will still be the start of every row that we do. And we're going to single crochet around. So we're going to do one single crochet inside the first half double crochet, another single crochet in the next stitch, then we're going to chain one, skip the next stitch, that third stitch, single crochet one in the next stitch, single crochet one in the next stitch. And this is essentially what we're going to be doing throughout the whole row, okay? So chain one, skip a stitch, and the next stitch, single crochet one again, next chain one, skip a stitch, single crochet another one, and that's what we're going to be doing all the way around, okay? Okay, so I'm at the end of my row. And now we're about to add ruffles to the top of the dome. This is what those loops look like, by the way. You can barely even tell. But when we go back into them later, it'll be a lot easier. Okay, so I'm going to do a color change, and how I'm going to do that is kind of similar to how we've been ending each row recently. So I decided to change the yarn that I was using before from loops and thread to just another red heart acrylic yarn, just because it's easier to show on video since it's not as fluffy. So I'm going to put my hook through the first single crochet that we've done. I'm going to take my new color, make sure there's still a loop on the hook, pull it through both loops, and then I'm just going to chain up two with my new color now, okay? Alright, and it's tight. I'll tie this and weave it in while also tying this and weaving this in later. We could pull this to make sure it's tight and there's no hole right there. And then we can go ahead, make sure there's a tail here, and cut that off so we could tie it and weave it in later, okay? Then with our new color, we will start doing our ruffles, okay? So I'm gonna chain one more. And then I'm going to single crochet two in each stitch, including the stitch that we just went into first, okay? So that was the chain three, okay? That's just to make sure there's no space. Again, it doesn't count as a stitch. I'm single crocheting two in the first stitch, single crocheting two in the second stitch, and we'll do this in every stitch all the way around, okay? That includes the chain one spaces, by the way. So we'll put two single crochet inside of the chain one spaces as well, okay? That way there's not like a gap. And this is essentially just how you make ruffles with anything. It's just adding increases, okay? Okay, so I'm done with that row. I'm at the end. You can already see it trying to create ruffles just with this one. Next, I'm going to do a row of half double crochet increases. First, to end this row, slip stitch into that first single crochet. Chain up two. Okay. I know we did that three last time, but it's fine. And I'm going to go inside the first stitch and half double crochet. Sorry, my tension was a little tight the last round. Half double crochet in the next stitch, and then increase every third stitch. I'm putting two half double crochet in the third stitch. And this is what we're doing for the whole row. Half double crochet one, half double crochet one, half double crochet two in that every third stitch. Okay? Alright, so I'm done adding ruffles to the top of the dome. You might have to manipulate the ruffles. So they could look a little more neat and nice, but you can do another row of single crochet going into increasing two in each stitch. But I'm not going to do that for now, just because it's so much more. And I think it looks pretty already. So to end this off, I'm going to just slip stitch into the first half double crochet we did. I'm gonna pull through the loop and I'm just gonna cut this into the tail and pull all the way through. Tighten it and then I'll weave it in, tie it and cut it off again later. So for the next part, what we're going to do is like we're going to go into our foundation chain and also add ruffles to the bottom. What we did up here, we're basically just going to do down here. Might be a little bit more difficult getting into the foundation chain though, as it's not the same as just going into a stitch. It's also optional if you want to go into the foundation chain. Or you can skip this part. I just like ruffles on both ends. I think it looks pretty. I'm going to show how to go in. I'm going to start with it like this. Okay. So kind of starting how we did, but the opposite. Okay, like the opposite side. I'm going to go into the first foundation chain. Okay, so I just finished. Just a recap on what I did to the top and the bottom is I single crocheted 2 in every stitch in every one foundation chain that we did. And then at the end of the row, I slip stitch into the first single crochet that we did, chained up 2. For the next row, I half double crochet 2. And then in every third stitch, I did an increase, okay? And this is the result at the end. I also went ahead and added my little charms and my little beads. I kind of sewed them on since I couldn't fit them on the yarn. Originally, I got some thread and pulled it through. Okay, so next we're going to talk about how to make the tentacles. Also, look guys, my charm, it changes. Like, I can flip it to what I want. How cutesy. Okay, so this is what the tentacles look like. There are more options in my written pattern, but for now, I'm just going to go over these two. This one is just clearly a basic chain. I chained, I want to say 70, but you can make them all different sizes just depending on what you want. And then I just cut it and boom. I want to leave loose ends for all my tentacles because we're going to put it in our bottom little panel, okay? At the bottom part of the dome, it's going to be easier to sew and just tie together, because what we're going to do is we're going to take the bottom, put the thread up to the top, and the tentacle will just hang from there. So that's why you want long threads, okay? So I'm going to move this out the way. Like I said, I'm only going to go over these two for my video tutorial. I have about 4 or 5 more options in my written pattern, but just for now, I'm going to do this one, okay? And I'm going to use my light blue. I'm going to do both dark blue and light blue. Like, I'll be using both tentacles. Start with the slip knot. And then I'm just going to chain 70 for this one as well. This is just the same as the Ruffles pattern, to be honest. I will chain 70 and then I'm going to half double crochet 2 in each chain, okay? And like I said, doing that will create ruffles, and that's exactly what it did. Okay, so I'll be back when I'm done. All right, I'm at the end of my chain. I did a chain of 70. Like I said, I'm just going to half double crochet 2 in each chain, not including the one on the hook, okay? So just 1, 2. 1, 2. And gradually, as you keep going, you will see that it will start twisting on its own. Okay. And I'll be back to show you the end result of this and how to cut it off. Okay, so I just got done with my last half double crochet. So I'm just going to chain 1, cut, and just pull that out. Okay, and tighten it. All right. And notice how, again, I left that loose end, okay? Also, you do not need to just chain 70. You could have it shorter or longer. Realize that it does stretch out a bit, okay? It's all up to how long you want your tentacles to be, and you'll probably have to kind of manipulate them to end up, like, as scrunchy as this is, okay? that's where that manipulation comes into play once again when it comes to ruffles. Okay, I'll do it later, but we want these ends kind of long still because we're going to attach them to the bottom of the dome, the base part now. And if you're planning on lining your bag, I would go ahead and do that before doing anything else. Like, this is where you want to line your bag now, okay? When you're done with this panel, your dome, and this. It's just easiest. So, this is the top part. This is the bottom. Can kind of tell the difference. The stitches look more clean and clear here. Okay, so I'm going to want to go into a random space. Let me work with the lighter yarn. Pull one of my tails through. Go into another space right next to it. Don't want to go too far. Pull that one through as well. And then I'll just tie them together. Okay, just tie them together. And then you could weave it in or you could cut it, tie it more however you want. I leave it there just as a placeholder for now, just in case I want to move it. I like to add all of them on before I go ahead and like cut anything, okay? So next I'm going to do this one, kind of near the edge as well. Just going in a random place, pulling through both of my tails and tying them together. And that's essentially the same for this one as well. I just take the yarn and kind of spread it through, since there's like four pieces of thread twisted in there. I just put them in half and I do the same exact thing. Okay, so I'm gonna go on a random, I'm gonna go more in the middle for my ones that are chains. Pull two of those threads through. Go in the next one. Make sure your chain isn't coming through like mine. Okay. And then same thing. Just tie it. Okay. And I'll come back when I have tied all of mine on. And I'll also show you guys how long they are and how many I did for each. Okay. Okay, so I just finished adding on all of my tentacles. Okay, so let's see. I did about 5 of the chain ones, and I want to say 6? Yeah, 6 of the half double crochet ones. Okay, and I spread them all out pretty much kind of evenly. I didn't do as much blue as I thought I needed to, like light blue as I needed to. Next, we're going to just add this piece on to our panel, okay? So, remember where that top is, the part where we had the little loops for our drawstring? You're going to get a piece of thread, preferably the same piece as your yarn. Okay, and you're gonna want it to be like a few inches more than your actual panel. So I'm gonna measure it like this. And then I'm just gonna take like extra, like that much extra. I feel like it's like 9 inches more. It'll be a lot extra, but it's okay. I'm gonna cut it. And you see why we go ahead and put the tentacles on before we sew it, just because it's easier. Sorry, my dog's in the background scratching her chair. Okay, so I'm gonna go through this first stitch, and I'm also gonna go in between the first row stitch that we did. So I'm gonna go like behind it, okay? And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take the end of my little piece of thread, and I'm just going to tie it for now as a placeholder for me to make that knot and then weave it in later. That's also why you want like a couple extra inches just in case, okay? This is just a placeholder. You could always take and undo the knot when you're ready, when you're done, okay? I'm going to keep my sewing needle on the thread, okay? What we're gonna do is we're just gonna go back and forth, okay? We're gonna go in the half double crochet we did here. We're gonna go behind the stitch once again, okay? And we're just gonna keep doing that back and forth, right? Next stitch, behind that next stitch. Okay. And I'm just gonna do that the entire time, okay? Just going down each stitch. And it's not the most ideal method of sewing. So if you have a better way, that's fine. Just make sure you're like getting each stitch, because there's 90 stitches in our dome and then 90 stitches on the bottom too. Like, they just line up pretty evenly. But if you have another method that works, feel free to use it. We're just attaching the bottom piece and nobody will really see it, so it is okay. All right. Oh, freak. My needle got stuck. Okay. Luckily, it's plastic, because I feel like the metal ones would start to tangle. I feel like I'm too rough with it, but anyway, I'll show you what it looks like when I get all the way through. This is it so far. And to pull it, to close it, you just pull it, basically, and it doesn't look too bad, okay? Okay, so I'm on my last one. I'm back to the beginning. And this is already tied. I already tied this part, so like the start string. So now I'm just gonna tie the last part to that. And then weave them in. Okay, I'll weave it in off camera. Next, what we're gonna do, it's starting to shape up like a bag, guys. Look at that. Like, this is an opening of the bag. It's weird. It's cute. It's weird right now. It's giving jelly. Okay. Okay, next, I think what we should do is probably go ahead and make the chain for the loops. Now, you can choose how much you want to chain. I'm going to chain the same color as my ruffles. I'm going to chain maybe like 110. So you want it to be able to go all the way around and then have extra to like for people to pull without it being too short to like go through the hole and slip out again, and not being too long just to look a little weird and off, you know? So I'm gonna try to do 110 and see what that looks like first. So I'm just gonna do a slip knot and then just start chaining. If you want, if you prefer, you can chain however long or short you want it to be, and then half double crochet it or single crochet to make it more stable, you know? So you're not just like pulling this chain as the drawstring. You can make it a little stronger, okay? Alright, I'm looking at it already, and like 110 is definitely not enough, especially since I guess I did 90. So I'm gonna keep going and just let you guys know what I ended up with. I'm gonna like thread it through to see, and then I'm just gonna like keep going. So I go ahead and show you guys how I threaded it through. And I'm gonna leave my chain open, that way I can still do trial and error with this. So I'm gonna insert this part in the back, okay? Because this will be the half that goes all the way around, and then the other half I'll have to finish. It'll go around, and this will be my front, okay? This is the back, all right? So I'm gonna go in through this loop. That's where my one of my loops are. Essentially, it doesn't matter where I start in the back as long as it comes out through the front here in two places. Okay, I'm pulling my chain through using my crochet hook, and see, it's just very easy to go through knowing where those loops are that we made earlier. I don't really have to count or anything because I can kind of see what we did before. And that's basically just how you thread it through. That's how the drawstring is. And then when you pull it, boom, it'll tighten up, okay? Loosen it, blah, blah, blah. Y'all know. Okay, so I just finished and I did a little trial and error off camera. And I think 150 is going to be my magic number personally. It also depends on the yarn you use and your tension when it comes to chaining as well, okay? Also, I forgot to measure my tentacles, I think. Sorry, it was stuck in a box. So, I'd say about, like, 13 inches, but it can stretch more. Okay? Here it is. Can it go to 10? I'm pretty sure it could go even to, like, 8 if I were to re-scrunch it. Okay, so I'm gonna finish threading my chain through my thing and then I'll come back. Okay, so we're finally pretty much done. The only thing we have left to do is literally just the strap, which is a consistent pattern, so it's fine. That'll be easy. Here's the bag. It's kind of square like, but as soon as you put stuff in it and close the drawstring, it'll give that jellyfish shape. Look how cutesy that is. Okay, wait till I put some stuff in it. Hold on. Okay, guys, do not judge the fit. This isn't what I was making the tutorial in. Totally. This, I had on something better. Definitely. 100%. Okay? But look, it's so cutesy. Okay? It's kind of holding its shape. Look at that. My phone's in it. Like, my phone's pretty heavy, too. But look. It looks like the jellyfish from SpongeBob. And look at the little bubbles I put. Okay, y'all see that? That's so cute. I'm getting too excited. The strap isn't even on. But it's okay. Alright, look. Okay, let's get this strap done before this becomes an unfinished project for me, okay? If you made it this far, I'm proud of you, okay? So basically, like I said, the strap is just a consistent pattern. We're going to do a slip knot, and the length and the width is completely up to you. If you want it to be thick, you can do more chains here. If you want it to be longer, you can do more rows, okay? So I'm just going to chain like 6, 4, 5, 6. And then I'm going to skip that 6th stitch, and I'm going to half double crochet in the 5th chain. I'm going to skip that 6th chain, I mean. And then half double crochet in the 5th. Okay? And we're going to half double crochet in each one going forward. And at the end of every row, we're going to only chain 1. Okay? Then after that, chain 1, you're going to want to turn your work and then half double crochet into the next 5 stitches. And again, once you get to that last stitch, you're just going to chain 1. Turn your work again. Start over. Half double crochet 5, and this is what it's going to be like until you get the length that you want. I'm doing a shoulder bag, not really a purse. It seems like it fits shoulder bag more, but I'm 5'1", so I'm going to probably do about like 100 rows of this total. I already counted based on past bags that I've done. And I think I will just, like, the only thing that I'll do off camera again is add ruffles to the sides of my straps. Just because we know how to make ruffles already. It's the same pattern as the tentacles, and it's the same pattern as the top and the bottom of the dome. So essentially you're just doing this, like, half double crochet 5, chain 1, turn your work, half double crochet 5, chain 1, turn your work over and over for as many rows as you want. Okay, so I'll be back and I'll measure mine once I'm done.
Okay, if you stayed this long, thank you. I'm outside because I'm about to take some clips of my bag, but I finished sewing on my strap. I did 100 rows of half double crochet and then I sewed it to each side of the bag. Okay, I added some little accessories. I added my jellyfish holder and a shrimp made by my friend. Okay. Okay, not gonna lie, this is kind of awkward because I'm just walking back and forth in front of my neighbor's yard. Like, I feel like they're looking at me funny through their window. So, thanks for watching, guys.